Hi, let's talk about how you figure the amount of glass, the volume of glass needed to fill your mold if you're going to do a glass casting. There are several ways to do this, but by far the simplest is displacement. So before I go into this little description here, understand that displacement is a concept. There's many ways to do displacement, and they all deal with volume. Basically, you are trading one volume for another, in this case water. So I've got my plaster silica mold here. I know where my line is for where my casting is going to be. I'm going to take water here, fill up a cylinder, mark it where that water was, pour the water in, coming up to the level that I want my casting to be. You'll notice it's down from the top of the mold a little bit. That's typically because we usually add a little bit of space below the casting, in this case, when you flip the mold over, above the casting. It's a reservoir for you to hold more glass in there. Some people call it a pour cup, whatever. But I'll have a mark inside my mold where I want the glass to come to, but I don't want necessarily the glass to go all the way to the top, not often. Pour my water into there. Of course, that's gonna mean that the water level drops. Now I've got all that empty space, but I have my mark. Then I'm gonna take chunks of glass, dump it in there until that water level rises back up to the same mark. Now I know once I dump all the water out, that's the amount of glass that I need, because that much glass is taking up that much space, which is the space that I dumped out into here. So that's displacement. What I'm gonna do now is a real-time demonstration of actually how that works using water in a mold, and talk through some of the more important details of that process. So the first thing you're going to need is the mold into which you're going to cast. The best time to do this is directly after you've made the mold, when it's saturated with water. If your mold has sat around for a few days and it is dry, you're going to need to saturate it with more water so that it does not absorb water when you pour into it. That's gonna become obvious in a few minutes why. So, I'm gonna fill this mold up with some water. And let it sit for a second. The next thing I'm gonna need is something that is that has markings on it, or that I can put markings on that I can fill up. So this is just a graduated cylinder. I could use something like this. I could use a clear Tupperware container, whatever. But I need something that I can fill up with water and mark. So I'm gonna fill this up to this black mark here. I'm gonna try to be as precise as I possibly can, to the point where I'm always gonna use this set down in the same place, in the same orientation, so that I know that that's level. If it's on a different surface, it could be tilted, and I could have a little bit of a discrepancy in the line. That becomes important if you're using a really large cylinder like this, because if you imagine the surface area of this is quite large. And so if I was off by a 16th inch, a 16th multiplied by the surface area of this is a solid chunk of glass. And that could be the difference between totally filling your mold or not, or overfilling your mold or not. So now I've got my mold saturated. I'm gonna hold it level. I'm gonna pour the water from here into it, taking care not to spill. There we go. Now, really important, I'm not filling all the way to the top. I'm filling to the edge of the pour cup. We made a pour cup, a little reservoir of glass. Reservoir for glass, it'll help hold all that glass in there. But also it means that when we go and fill this up, if I'm a little off in my measurements, it won't pour over the side, and I've got a lot of cold working to do. So now the level of my water has gone down, right? What I'm gonna do is really simple. Set this back exactly where it was. And I have got some nuggets of glass here, what we use to charge the furnace. And I'm just gonna keep dumping them in there until the water comes back up to that line. So now, the glass that's in there has taken up the space. It represents the volume of water that I poured into the mold. Now, I'm gonna dump all the water out. And I'm gonna weigh this glass. Got myself a handy plastic bag. Now I've got the weight of the glass that I need. I will go and I will weigh it. And then when it comes time for me to do the glass that I really want to fill in there, whatever that glass is, if it's the same type of glass or close, then I have the same weight. Since most soda lime glass weighs about the same, we should be spot on. So those are the basics. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.